nightmare. Ha 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 ha.
To tell about this guy, you all know him, he's scared as hell. He comes to me at night after I crawl into bed. He's burnt up like a weenie and his name is Fred. He wears the same hat and swear every single day. And even if it's hot outside, he wears it anyway. He's gone when I'm awake, but he shows up when I'm asleep. I can't believe it, there's a nightmare on my street. It was Saturday evening, if I remember it right. And we had just gotten back off tour last night. So the gang and I thought that it would be groovy if we summoned up the posse and done watch the movie. I got Andy, Jeff got Tina, Ray Rack got some girl I'd never seen in my life. That wasn't right because the lady was chill. Then we dipped to the theater, set to ill, buggin', cool, having a ball. And something about Elm Street was the movie we saw. The way it started was decent, you know, nothing real fancy about this homeboy named Fred and this girl named Nancy. But then when it was over, I said, yo, that was death. And everything seemed alright when we left. But when I got home and laid down to sleep, that began a nightmare on my street. It was burning in my room like an oven. My bed soaked with sweat and man, I was bugging. I checked the clock and it stopped at 12:30. And it melted and was so darn hot and I was thirsty. I wanted something cool to quench my thirst. I thought to myself, yo, this heat is the worst. But when I got downstairs, I know that something was wrong. I was home all alone, but the TV was on. And thought nothing of it as I grabbed the remote. I pushed the power button, and then I almost choked when I heard this awful voice coming from behind. He said, man, I ain't even wait to see who it was. Broke a saw in my drawers, screamed so long, cuz got halfway up the block, I calmed down, stopped screaming, and thought, oh, I get it, I must be dreaming. I stroll back home with the grin on my grill. I think that since this isn't true, I might as well get ill. I walked in the house, the big bad fresh prince. But Frey killed all that noise real quick. He grabbed me by my neck and said,
here's what we'll do. We got a lot of blood here, me and you. The souls of your friends, you and I will play. You've got the body and I got the brain.
I said, yo, Fred, I think you got me all wrong. I ain't partners with nobody with nails that long. Look, I'll be honest, man, this team won't work. The girls will be a yo and Fred, your face is all burnt. Fred got mad, his head started steaming. But I thought, what the hell, I'm only dreaming. I said, please leave Fred so I can get some sleep. But give me a call, maybe we'll hang out next week. I pat him on the shoulder, said thanks for stopping by. Then I opened up the door and said, take care, guy. He got mad, drew back his arm, and slashed my shirt. I laughed at first and thought, hold up, that hurt. It wasn't a dream, man, this guy was for real. I said, Freddy, pal's been off a mistake here. No further words, and then I darted upstairs. Crashed through my door, then jumped to my bed. Pulled the covers up over my head and said, oh, please do something with Fred. Jumped in my bed, looked through the covers with his claws, trying to get me. But my alarm went off and then silence. It was a whole new day, and I thought, I wasn't scared of him anyway. Until I noticed those rips in my sheets, and that was proof that it had been a nightmare on my street. Oh man, I gotta call Jeff.
Come on,
Jeff, answer! Come on, man. Jeff, it's Christmas. Jeff, wake up!
What do you want?
Jeff, wake up, man. Listen to me, Jeff. Jeff, listen, Jeff, would you listen to me? Whatever you do, don't fall asleep. Jeff, listen to me, don't go to sleep. Jeff! 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 Jeff!
Ah!